My name is Ahmed, and I'm from Mugyagi. So my friends, my Muslim brothers and Imam, they call me Ahmed Mugyagi.
Okay.
Yeah, this is my place. But my name actually is Ahmed Kemi.
Kemi.
Yeah, my Christian name is Peter.
Peter. Oh, okay.
Yeah, so.
So you become from Peter to Ahmed.
So and.
How many years before you became Muslim?
Since I left, I was in grade 6.
Okay.
From a primary school, and then left the school without going to high school. So from there I did some criminal activities with going around with the youths, doing some bad activities. And I ended up in prison many times. So I spent almost, after completing my grade 6 in 1986,
okay.
I ended up in prison 97, and then 88, 89, maybe I was still out there doing all this rubbish. And then finally, my friends, we got drunk. I met a guy who is near my neighborhood. So he came to live with me. There's a flat run by an Australian government called YMCA. YMCA and YWCA. It's, YWCA is for Young Women Association. YMCA is for Young Men Association. So actually I took over the building, and because the Australian government, they left the place. So they moved it back to PNG, and then I took the place. And then I own the place, so whoever lives in there, I chased them out because I was a bad guy. People got feared and ran away. So I got the place. There's a gym and everything. Basketball court, it's a big flat, you know. The one class, they came and rent, and they pay rent to me. So I own the place now, so I stay there, and then the guy who lived in that one of the flat cooks a meal, and then said, come, let's eat some meal together. So we ate. And he was talking to me about Islam. And when finally I came and had it, he said, Jesus is not God, so... My Christian background is, we came from a Christian family, and when I was small, I got into Christian
church
and all this, you know, classes and all this. So
you were a strong Christian?
Yes. But and then I grown up, and then I went into bad activities again. So, but I still believe in, you know, Jesus as a God.
Yes. So someone tell you some God?
Yes. That's I told Isha, you know, Isha something like, the devil or something, you know. So I said, no, I don't want to listen to you. I'm not going to eat your, you know, dinner too, so I have to leave. Yeah. Although I do bad activities, but I don't say this thing, you know. I respect the
Jesus
as a God, so how can I, you know, say, listen to you? But and then, as time goes by, 1 or 2 years passed, and then I meet another, my friend, his name is Abdul Basit. But he got embraced 2 days earlier than me. And then he came and he saw me. I was so drunk. And after, you know, spending the night drinking and smoking drugs and all this. And when the sun rise, I was about 8, 9, I was so weak. So he whispered to my ear, said, I know one place, a very good place. People there will comfort you, you'll drink cold water, you'll sleep, rest yourself. So we go. So he put me. We came to Imam's house.
Okay.
That was the place where they, you know, start off with their religion, Islam in this country. I never know that this was a religion organization. So I went in there. They told me to sit down. They comforted me. And then my friend Abdul Basit, he told Imam, while I was not concentrating, because I am moved in drug and all this, they can see my eyes that, you know, it's getting red, and you know, so I have to put my head down to avoid them, you know. But he's talking to, he's whispering to Imam that, you know, this guy is in a bad mood and all this. So after that, Imam told me, he came and tapped my hands and gave me some cold water, some, you know, small rice, and then he said, he was talking to me about, you know, drugs and alcohol, all this, you know, it's bad. He was telling me it's bad, don't do it, don't like it. So I was thinking, this guy, you know, how does he know that I'm getting all this and I'm, you know, involving in this activity? But my friend actually briefed him, but, you know, he never knew that. So, and then he finally explained to me about Islam. And then they call Azan and they were praying in front of me. So, you know, the religion makes me look like it's sense, you know. But because of the Arabic language and all this, I'm a bit confused, you know. I was thinking.
Does it look like easy access or something?
Yeah. No, like the form of worship is like, it's like, you know, it's a respect or something, you know. It's a good way of worship, but.
So the salah when they
but,
pray.
But because the language terms that they're using it, because it's in Arabic, I was a bit, you know.
Not sure.
So they might say something, you know, wrong or something like that. So I just observed and wait there. Another time I went back. But because the Imam and the brothers there, they were very friendly. And then they gave me Christian-Muslim dialogue. And then GS one message, one message came after, but GS, not the Son of God and all this, you know. They brought those books from Egypt. So I was not a good reader, but anyway, I, you know, read through and then got some understanding from there, and then finally I realized that, you know, I find something truth. And in my mind, or as a Christian before, I was thinking, how can, you know, a man like Jesus create the universe and, you know, the air and the sky and the oceans, you know, it's impossible. I was thinking,
yes,
that was in my mind.
You already had that question, yeah, yes.
In my mind, so with that, you know, I was, yes. I can pick it up from there.
Yes, so you could relate more to Islam straight away.
Yes, yes.
That Allah created everything,
yeah,
and Jesus and everyone.
Yes, that's right.
And then you became Muslim.
I declared my Shahada.
Now 25 years, yeah?
After 25 years.
I'm sure many more people become Muslim through you.
Yes, I got two wives. I got one wife with 4 kids, and they all were born Muslims. And then after, finally, I went for Dawah in Highlands, and then I found another lady that she wants to become Muslim, so she became Muslim, and then she came to declare Shahada, and then we also get married. Now she got 2 kids. We're all living together in one half place, and I brought many brothers and sisters to Islam. And their kids, they are coming, and they finally find out that, you know, from my village, one part of the place I came from, which is Chibu, which none of our brothers became Muslim. And then now the community is like this brother, our small son here, his father became Muslim through me, and he's got 3-4 sons coming to Islam, his wife, and then there's more coming.
A few families,
yeah,
all coming.
They're coming. So inshallah, in future, we should have a bigger number of family of Muslims.
So you have any? Do you have any message for Australia?
Sorry?
Any message for Australia?
Yes.
Yeah,
our brothers, we are very happy to, if they can kindly assist us with some more books. Dawah books, like especially based on Christianity beliefs.
The books you told, Muslim,
yes,
Christian
dialogue, Muslim
Jesus
dialogue,
God or not.
Jesus the Son of God or not the Son of God, and the truth about Jesus, and just one message, and those are the books that link to Christianity, to open their hearts, our minds. That is the only
thing
we need.
Yes.
Yes.
Well, like, except for